Do you ever look at yourself one day and think you are hottish, but the next day comes and you've become Quasimodo? Why do you think this happens? I know I'm a handsome man from the front but have a weird head shape from the side, so I avoid turning my head at all times. Yeah, my side profile looks really unattractive to me. I'll be feeling confident looking in the mirror some days, then turn to the side and it's like a whole new weird looking person. Especially my hairstyle and nose. I just try and remember that it's because I'm not accustomed to seeing my side profile. We don't think about this of others like friends and family because we get a consistent viewing of their entire profile all the time. Are you me? Because I thought I was the only person that felt this way. 100% exactly how I feel. I've always hated my profile. It's the worst and has been a source of discomfort for me since middle school. Kids can be cruel as we all know. Finding out you have a flat face in the 6th grade sucks. So like if you're at a party where there's a girl you like, you're just like an owl all night making sure she doesn't see the side of your head. Try to keep eye contact. Either it will work and you will get her attention or she will label you a creep. No in between. Me too. I hate my side profile. I think most people do. We're not used to seeing ourselves from the side. If I'm far enough away from the mirror I look okay. I look better closer emo. 100% sure I angered a very petty warlock at some point in my youth or adolescence. It'd explain a lot. Really. 100% sure I angered a very petty warlock. HMM. Are you a hunter or titan? I look great in my mirror when getting ready to go out. Then I show up in pictures looking like crap. Lol. I call it my magic mirror. I noticed when I moved into another rental house that I looked really weird in the bathroom mirror. It made me look pale and overall just not as attractive. I've lived here a year now and I always feel like I look good in it. I think this magic mirror thing is because we become accustomed to consistently seeing ourselves, and thus perceiving ourselves, as the image in the mirror we use almost every day. So when we see ourselves in a different lighting and area we feel like we look weird because we're not used to that version of us. Just try and remember that others do not view our imperfections as harshly as we do. I think you're absolutely right. I went to a museum of illusion a few months back and they had a magic mirror but this mirror made you see yourself as others saw you. It essentially flipped the image and I couldn't comprehend it. I didn't recognize myself for a split second but when I did I started seeing things I'd never noticed and there was serious cognitive dissonance between my mental image of me and what I was seeing. Also keep in mind we're not symmetrical. So when you look in a mirror you're looking at a mirror image, duh, of your face. Front facing cameras do the same thing. But when you see yourself in a photo, you're looking at what you look like to the rest of the world. It's not unlike hearing your voice through a recording. It doesn't sound quite right so you feel uncomfortable. When you look at a photo you look slightly different than what you're used to seeing. Your mirror image, same. You always look great in your mirror at home. And then when you see yourself in a picture mirror at school or work, you look horrendous. I've read that this happens because you are comfortable with your reflected view of yourself. When you see your face in a picture, as your face is asymmetrical, you look funny to you. As with your head voice vs your recorded voice. Ovulation. Was just going to post this. Ovulation makes me gorgeous. 2 days later and I'm a troll again. It's natural entrapment. Lol at natural entrapment. Ovulating I stand up too fast and double over from ovarian pain. But look amazing. 2 days later I'm breaking out. 2 days later my uterus has imploded and I look like an adolescent whale. 5 days later. Today, after showering and moisturizing I look amazing. A refined roller coaster. That is, my IUD is only 3 years old but I already want to replace it because goddamn I miss that 2.5 years where I didn't have periods. This is what I've noticed also. Around ovulation, women will tend to think damn, I look really good today. It has to do with estrogen being at its highest and a small testosterone surge. It's nature's way for fertile women to attract a mate. Never thought of this but it makes sense. Semi-related. But I cannot figure out for the life of me why I'm always at my horniest during my period. I feel like that's not how it's supposed to work. Sorry if that's TMI. Yes. Please elaborate. I am currently ovulating. I think there have been studies that show when a woman is ovulating, males find her more attractive and the same can be said for people she likes. Possibly the woman finds herself more attractive too. hormone influx in general. I feel better about myself some days and not good about myself other days because of emotional symptoms of PMDD. Put my contacts in. Yep. Always think I look pretty after doing my hair and putting makeup on. Then glasses. And boom, no longer look pretty. For what it's worth. Most people don't notice the smaller details, but we do because we know our own faces very well. You need to actively think to see someone else's smaller acne, but to yourself your acne are the first thing someone sees. Because it's out of place or a flaw you're aware of, that's so you can have a rom-com style glow up. Nope, but I have had moments where I looked in the mirror and thought, what if I had some disability but was unable to see it, and no one was going to tell me to be nice. Bro, are you me? Some days I am 100% convinced people are just playing along and I'm just mentally handicapped. Like, how would I even know? Everyone I know is too nice to tell me. I feel like I'm at Truman's Show but for dumb. I feel like I'm at Truman's Show but for dumb is my favorite, most relatable, and most heartbreaking quote I've heard in quite a while. People aren't that nice. Quantity of water vs alcohol I've had. Well, hydrated and sober looks a lot better. You sound just like my goddamn mom. Drink your water, UL Popster. Maybe refrain your alcohol consumption, UL Popster. We all think you might have a serious problem, and we're worried about you. Gets super annoying. That's when you just ignore that hater and slam back another 40 AM I write my peoples. Ha 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 ha. My mom used to bang pots and pans when she thought any of us may have been hungover. Awa turn words. Dude, this sub is absurdly amazing. F off. I'm drunk right now and look majestic as F. I know I'm going to wake up tomorrow and realize how pathetic I look. Promise myself I'm going to work out and eat right. And then get drunk and look in the mirror and say damn you're sexy and go to bed happy. Beer goggles work on yourself apparently. If you chug one glass of water right now, you'll be less hungover in the morning. I feel the opposite. Nothing beats that dry lean look of dehydration after a night of drinking. If I'm well hydrated, I'm just a blob. I think it's based off mood. Like if I had a great day and life is just bending over for me, then yeah, I'll look like Zeus on his 18th birthday. But when life bends me over, goddamn, I look like Frankenstein's monster's pet dog. So I think it's just mood. Frankenweenie. Okay, this is a little unrelated, but when I was like 6 or something, I saw a trailer for that movie and I got so scared that I cried and hyperventilated for like 4 hours lmao. This happens to me all the time. It really depends on how much sleep I got, how I look at that moment, and how my day has gone. Lighting is a big influence. There was a GIF I saw on Reddit a while back showing a light circling someone's face, and they looked different every second. Also, if you're pale as F like me, you'd probably look better in yellow lighting than white. Looking at myself in the mirror versus looking at photos of myself. For some reason, when we see the reverse of what we're used to, it looks like effing trash. You don't mock my boy Quasimodo like that. Respect. If you're a person with a uterus, your monthly hormonal cycle plays a really killer role in how you feel perceive yourself. I think it's one of the cruelest jokes that I look my hottest at about day 3 of my period, despite having no desire to get laid then. Damn, this is actually eye-opening. This explains why my GF has days where she is absolutely feeling herself, sending selfies and showing off to her friends, and other days where she'll be crying about how she thinks she looks like a potato and saying things like, why are you even attracted to me? To me, I just find she looks exactly the same. You know when you're jacking off to porn and the porn is absolutely amazing and then you come and are disgusted by the porn you're watching? Every time. That's when you're supposed to make the important decisions. Abby. Do you like that? Very quickly followed by Jesus. Look how he is treating this woman. E. My most upvoted comment. Mom, would you look at me now? Women-friendly porn exists. Support that industry. Worse is when you catch your reflection in it. I don't need a reminder of how effing ugly I am when I'm jacking off. Believe me, I know. And that is Black Mirror. But it's like as soon as I come to my senses. Lil Wayne nailed it. Seriously. Post Bit Me has actually felt sick after seeing what Prenut Me was looking at. Safe sex is great sex. Better wear a latex cause you don't want that late text. That I think I'm late text. He's had lots of great ones. OMG, I thought I was the only one. As a gay man who watches gay and hetero porn, I felt disgusted after watching gay porn and made me question my own sexuality. But now that I see, I think it may be normal. After coming, you feel disgusted. It might be due to addiction or chronic use of porn. When you watch porn for many years, you start to get desensitized and escalate to more exotic content to get the dopamine high you're looking for. Check the effects of porn on the brain. It's a refined drug. I think it also depends on lighting. Under some lights you may look nice, but others maybe not. Till, I need to stay in the dark. Sometimes I close my eyes in the shower. Arsusa Debbie Woods. Damn bro, do you need a hug? Damn you dead. That's exactly why sometimes when you try clothes on you look good in the fitting room. But then when you try it at home, not so much. I've had to take clothes to the window for sunlight to make sure what color I was actually buying. Some stores are so damn dark. Actually, there are these things called skinny mirrors that make you look like you're 10 pounds lighter. She's a two-face. Ah, bad lighting on that porch. And what shirt you're wearing. As a guy, I have a few shirts that flatten the tum and enhance the shoulders, so I look, to me, rather fit, but I'm not. It's my little motivator though. Slowly, I will be shirtless and look the same way. This may also explain why some photos are so flattering and others are like WTF. Photos can seem really unflattering because the image you see of yourself in the mirror is flipped and the image in a photo is the right way around. Well, depending, because some software on front-facing cameras won't flip it around correctly. So it's not that your true orientation looks worse, you're just not used to it. Aside from that, photos are a two-dimensional representation of three-dimensional objects, so depending on the type of lenses, it flattens you out to varying degrees. This can actually be flattering depending on the type of face you have. Partly responsible for some being photogenic. Posture plays a big part in it. If you wake up feeling really good, your posture is going to reflect that and everything about your body gets a little boost with that. If you wake up feeling gross, your posture is worse and you end up more scrunched up, which looks less attractive. Confidence plays a role too, but if you wake up and you think you're looking worse than usual, try fixing up your posture. Any tips on unscrunching? Roll your shoulders backwards, opening your chest up. Do this for a bit and loosen up. Then put your arms out by your sides, palms facing forward, and roll your shoulders up and back and try to find that spot where your shoulders seem to rest on your back. Let them sit in that spot and hold this position for a minute or so and take deep breaths. Your chest may feel tight when you breathe, but the more you do this the better it will be. I hope this makes sense. I've been doing this for about 30 seconds to 1 minute every few hours and I've noticed a huge improvement with my posture and neck back pain. That neck and back pain is often from looking down at your phone or computer for long periods or just any work where you are scrunching forward. It's becoming a very common issue for many people. Yoga. So many people are tight in the chest and front of their shoulders, which leads to that rounded upper back posture. If you can work on releasing the tension in the front of the shoulders and chest, you'll find it's easier to relax the shoulder blades down your back and elevate the front chest and neck into a more upright position. Look up beginner shoulder opening stretches and a few minutes a day is all it takes to make some incredible progress fairly quickly. IDK why it happens, but I agree that it does. Well, if that isn't cased closed, I don't know what is. I think sometimes moods change. Some days you're J. Would you F me? I def me so hard. And other days you just wake up and you're not your type that day. Which is okay. We don't close cases around these parts. We end threads. Or, if you're a mod of our games, you just delete the whole thread. Right after a haircut, and I've actually paid attention to what I'm wearing. I'll never interact with another human. Pumping gas at 8 a.m. Unshowered and in sweatpants. Half of high school alumni pull up. Yeah, but if you pump gas in your sweats at 8 a.m. unshowered once a week but only get your hair cut once every 6 months, that's to be expected. Lighting quantity. Color and direction. Hydration. Lower meaning less bloat. Please don't dehydrate yourselves. Occupancy of digestive tract. Some stuff can take a while to work its way through you. I'm sure there are other factors. I feel like hair makes a big difference. Like if I'm getting ready for a date or something, my hair looks worse the more I try style it, but if I've been working all day and sweating under a hard hat, it suddenly looks amazing. Oh yeah, I've definitely taken plenty of shots where I looked 5 pounds skinnier after. People don't think it be like it is, but it do. It really do be like that sometimes. I think it could be a mixture of things. Bloating and swelling due to high sodium intake. or drinking alcohol the day before could make your face look a bit bigger. How hydrated you are and how well you slept will also affect your skin and darkness under your eye, as well as puffiness under the eye. Your body and stomach can always change due to bloating or just not taking a sh. Your face can also wear the outline of the last expression you were holding for a long while, be it resting bee face, a look of worry or stress, or anger. All of this stuff can fluctuate throughout the day and week greatly, and frankly that's normal. Having a regular healthy diet and self-care practices help. But ultimately I just hold on to the image of how you looked best recently and know most people don't look at you with such scrutiny as you probably do to yourself. My last pregnancy I thought I was the most beautiful goddess in the world the entire pregnancy. This was despite gaining 70 pounds, vomiting multiple times daily, peeing myself each time I vomited, popping all the veins in my legs and farting non-stop. I guess I mean to say that I think hormones play a role in how you perceive yourself. Because humans are unnecessarily complicated and a lot have self-esteem issues. And my main concern how someone can go from hot to having a serious birth defect overnight. People say it's all about perspectives and stuff. But I do believe there's one particular mirror in my house that's got some bad beef with me. The chef's always effing with me. One day I look gorgeous and couldn't be happier. Then, the next day, I just look like a whole train ran me over and that's just it. I can't get rid of it. I'm afraid that mirror might get its revenge on me if I did. It's all about the lighting. Overhead is unflattering. But eye level? Oh, I'm a model. It's all about confidence. If you're feeling good then you'll think you look good. I don't think it's just confidence. Sometimes I wonder if it's diet, the amount of sleep I've had, hormone fluctuations, water retention, and or dehydration. But then also probably some psychology could be involved. Yeah, getting no sleep the night before makes you look like sh. Your skin, your eyes, your hair, it's a chemical thing in the brain. When you're working out, you're releasing endorphins which make you feel good, which make your outlook on the world a little more kind. Mood swings, autism, depression, similar. I have ADHD and currently have no health insurance so no medication. I've been struggling a lot with self-hatred. Forgetting simple things like my name tag for work which I need every day but I forgot it 9 times out of 10. Then my boss saying why can't you just remember? Because that's now how my brain works. I feel useless, stupid, and ugly because my brain doesn't work the way everyone else's does. Sure I'm creative and make tons of artwork, but I can only focus on that and my pets. When I lived with my ex he'd say it's incredible how you can always remember to feed and brush and cut your dog's nails, but you literally can't remember where you put your wallet or phone charger. I don't know how you live like that. Well, it's not a choice buddy. Every comment someone makes on my poor attention span or lack of short-term memory hurts so bad because I cannot control it. I have a friend who has autism and he relates to this very well. It's hard to love yourself when you look in the mirror and see failure from everyone's comments. Autism? Ha. For me. I know why it happened. We recently adopted 3 children aged 2, 2, and 3. Previously that month, I had to show my ID for my wine purchase. 6 months later, I got asked if my mom was my younger sister. Talk about a big F you to my hopes of not looking like Quasimodo to anyone else. Lol. Yes. It's my freaking hair. It can be perfectly fine one day, but then I skip a shower and the next I'm constantly scratching my scalp and my hair is so greasy and duty sticks up everywhere and Jesus Christ it annoys me. I'm 23 and balding. Hair is ridiculously important to self-image. Believe me. Never thought it would be. I used to practically brag about how I didn't have to wash or comb my hair cause it didn't matter. Hair matters. There's a problem. You're skipping your shower.